A very good evening to all my Health Talk viewers and my good friends on YouTube. This is Mrs. Raina Khatri Tandon, a breakthrough coach, a woman entrepreneur, an NVC specialist, a posh trainer, and areas of behavioral skill training. Today we are on a very interesting topic. It's okay to be imperfect. We are always WIP models, a work in progress. Let me take you through a little story, and this is a real-time experience which made me look and ponder upon this topic. Of course, before I start the topic, if you have any queries after I have done with the story and you do feel there is a need where you would want to discuss, of course I have written down my email address, my contact numbers and my connects on social media for LinkedIn and Facebook, which is Raina Khatri Tandon, because many a times there have been instances in our life where we need a person to listen and talk to about what's going on inside us. And non-violent communication plays a very important role in both listening and putting ahead our feelings, needs and thoughts across to a person. Based on the observations, we can place our inferences and place the request to the person who's really dear to us in front of us, whether it's our personal life or our professional life. So let us understand what triggered this thought and wanted to share with each one of you today. A few days back, as I was walking down my garden walk during the evening hours, me and my son were playing around and we found one of his friends in the garden not wanting to play. So the boy came up and he was sitting in the corner along with me, and I quickly was thinking, though he was very excited to see the others play, he didn't want to go and play. So I was very intrigued to asking him, why are you not playing? And he said, because, you know, I feel that I can't play as good as they can play. I can't hit the football as high as they can play. And I said, why do you feel that? He said, because constantly I have been told at home that, you know, I need to improve. I need to always be good as much as XYZ. I'm supposed to be going for sessions. I'm supposed to be eating this. I'm supposed to gain stamina. And only then I will become a great player. And I said, so those are things which should inspire you to play. But then he said that I do not want to be a football player. I only go because I like to play. I do not want to approach it as a profession. I want to be an artist. And my parents don't want me to be an artist. They want me to be a football player because my dad is a cricketer. So I said, that's interesting. So here we have two conflicting minds where there is a parent telling something to do to the child and the child wanting to do something else. So I said, how do you know that you want to be an artist? So he's just pulled out his drawing book, which he always carries with him. And it was really amazing to see that he was such a great artist. I said, did you show this to your parents? He said, yes, I have showed it. And they say it's good. They appreciate it. But the only difference is they still want me to be a football player. And that's why I'm here. And so I said, why can't you become both? So he said, well, I've not thought about it. All I knew is probably I want to be only an artist. And I know that I'm not good at that. I said, if you are not good at it, you work till you become good at it. But we all are not good at everything. So I told him, let's take 1 minute and make a drawing. And let's draw what we like most. And believe me, he drew such a beautiful scenery in about a minute, and I could draw only those little boats and little mountains and little seas. And it was okay to even feel that imperfection, because I could still see the happiness he had at the end of the drawing, that he had conquered against me. And it was okay to even fail with him, because it was not my failure, but it was his victory which made me live for it. So I just showed in my drawing and I said, look what I have drawn and look what you have drawn. and he was very happy, and he was like, that's just not anything, and still you are happy. And I said, yes, because it's not the happiness of not drawing correctly, but the enjoyment which I had in spending that time with him. So eventually he understood that sometimes it's not about the success point, it's not about what you want to become, it's the journey of becoming that. And he said, I would want to play. That itself gave a big achievement and a great learning for all of us, that it's not always about becoming what you really want to become, but the journey of you enjoying each moment to become that is most important. So as much as he enjoyed that journey, I enjoyed being with him, enjoying my childhood moments of drawing and getting my wonderful self out. At the same time, he also understood that it's okay to be imperfect in one particular sport, but still enjoy it. And I wish all my wonderful viewers that please do understand that life is beautiful and you can never be perfect in all areas of life. It's okay to accept the way you are and not compare yourselves, not blame yourselves, not always being judged by others, not perceiving others talk in your head, but understanding that you are beautiful in the same way as you are. Having self-love, having an imperfect you is okay. But be beautiful and stay blessed. Thank you very much for listening to me. Always be a work in progress model, because that will make you always happier and explore into new things. Thank you very much.